Hello, welcome to next session. In this session, we will solve J2013 XCB fluid mechanics paper. First of all, one mass question. Question number one, the gauge pressure inside a soap bubble of radius R with sigma denoting the surface tension between the soap bubble, soap solution and air. Okay. Is option A sigma by 2 pi R, option B 4 sigma by R, option C 2 sigma by R, option D sigma by 4 pi R. Here we can see that the P pressure is acting inside the bubble and sigma surface tension are acting on the outer and inner surface. Okay, so here P is your area work P is your pi R square. Okay, this is P into pi R square, and surface tension in Newton meters, so we will take inner circumference as well as outer circumference. Okay, as the thickness is very small, so we can take R. Okay, so this is inner circumference or an outer circumference. We get multiply 2, then we get the circumference 2. Okay, so it will be sigma 2 pi R into 2 because of P into pi R still. Okay, so answer is your P is equal to 4 sigma by option B. Next, let M, B, and G represent respectively the metacenter, center, center of buoyancy, and center of mass of a floating body. Okay. Which of the following statement is correct? M is above G, body buoys stay unstable. Okay. B is above G. Buoy stable. See, M is above G, buoy stable. See, M is above G, buoy stable. B is above G, buoy unstable. So for floating condition, this is the stable condition. M should be above G and B. Okay, so M is above G. Next. A reservoir connected to a pipeline is being filled with water as shown in the figure. At any instant T, the free surface level in the reservoir is H. Find the time in seconds for the reservoir to get filled up to height of 1 meter if the initial level is 0.2 meter. Okay. And this is the reservoir of diameter 0.5 meter given. Okay. And free surface is at H. Okay. To get filled up to 1 meter. And now final height is 1 meter. Initial height is 0.2 meter. Okay. Now what is coming from here? And at a velocity 2 meter per second, diameter of this pipe is your 0.1 meter. And diameter of this reservoir is 0.5 meter. Okay. So this charge velocity is double as compared to this velocity. Okay. And area is same. So this charge here, so the water coming here is double of that water going out. Okay. So half of the tube will go into the tank, which will fill the tank. Okay. So the time to fill the tank from the when initial level is 0.2 meter, volume by net discharge, volume of the tank is your 0.5 diameter, so area is 5 by 4 d scale. Okay, and initial level is your 0.2 and final level is your 1. So that is the volume we have to fill. Okay, 1 minus 0.2. Okay, and now the net discharge is nothing but 40 to 1 meter. Okay, so this is your 5 by 4, the diameter is 0.1 square, 2 minus 1. Okay. So, putting these values, we can get P is equal to 20 seconds. Answer is the second option. Bernoulli's equation is valid for following type of load. Answer is D, incompressible, fully inducing. These are the assumptions in Bernoulli's equation. Next, if A is the area of the circle, of radius r enclosing a plane forced vertex with the origin at the center of the vertex, and if omega is angular velocity, tau is the symbol v. Is your vorticity and v your velocity vector, then the circulation around the counter circle is given by option A 2va, 2 omega A, option B 2 xi A, option C 2va, option D is given. So circulation is given by 2vrv, okay, where v is velocity and 2 pi r is your radius, okay. So v velocity, okay, and v velocity is nothing but omega 2 r, okay, area of the force versus, okay, so velocity will be at outer part, okay, omega r, okay, so it will be 2 pi r, area is your pi r scale, okay, so it will be 2 e omega 2 r, omega option A. Flow past a circular cylinder can be produced by superposition of following elementary potential flow. For circular cylinder, we can take doublet and a uniform flow. Okay. And because when the flow is entering, there is a source, and at the cylinder there is uniform flow, and at the doublet there is sink. Okay. Source entering forms doublet. Okay. And there is uniform flow. Okay. So answer is okay. Next, let delta 1, delta 2, delta 1, delta and delta 2 denote respectively the boundary layer thickness, displacement thickness and momentum thickness for laminar boundary layer flow of an incompressible fluid over a flat plate. The correct relation among these quantities is delta is less than delta 1, less than delta 2. So this is the answer. Because generally the boundary layer thickness is less than the displacement thickness and the momentum thickness is the highest. So we have to remember this, okay. This can be derived, but it is very, very low. Yes. Okay. But you have to remember that the boundary layer thickness is the minimum and the momentum thickness is the In the hydrodynamic entry region of a circular duct, the pressure forces balance the sum of viscous and buoyancy forces, B, inertia and buoyancy forces, C, inertia and surface tension forces, D, inertia and viscous tension. In hydrodynamic boundary layer, there is no buoyancy force and there is no surface tension force. Okay, these are negative. So only the inertia force, the pressure force only balance the inertia force. The buoyance force is when in a case of static equilibrium, static fluid, okay. And the surface tension is also in case of static fluid. So these are not considered. And when the flow takes with inertia and viscous force, becomes predominant, okay. So answer is B. The body with various cross-sectional shapes subjected to cross flow of air shown in the figure, shown in the following figure. The characteristic dimension of all the shape is same. The cross-sectional shape with largest coefficient of drag, that is sum of pressure drag and spin flexion drag at any moderately large Mohr number. So this is streamlined body. This is also approximately streamlined body. And this is completely bluff body, okay. And the separation will start from here, okay. From here, okay. And here the separation will start from a long distance. So, in this case, the CD will be large, okay. So, due to pressure difference, okay. So, answer is C. So, in case of streamlined body, the drag is slightly less. Okay. Next, 2 marks question. A U-tube of very small bore with its limbs in a vertical plane and filled with a liquid of density rho up to height of h is rotated about a vertical axis with an angular velocity of omega shown in the figure. The radius of each limb from the axis of rotation is r. Let PA and PA be the atmospheric pressure at g, the acceleration due to gravity. The angular velocity at which the pressure at the point O becomes half to the atmospheric pressure is given by. So this is your this is a figure given. This is the point O. This is height. This is at rotor and omega. So this is an option. Okay. Now the pressure at O when there is no rotation is rho g h. Okay. And when there is rotation, then this fluid will create centrifugal force. Okay. This mass of fluid. And mass of this fluid is area of this and this dimension is 2r. Okay. So rho a 2r is the mass of this fluid. Okay. And this is a mass and centrifugal force is mass into omega square into r. So this is the mass and this is omega square and this is r. Okay. Rho a 2r is mass. Omega square into r is centrifugal force. Okay. And if we divide the centrifugal, now the pressure at O after rotation is PA by 2. Okay. PA by 2. Okay. Now if we have centrifugal force, if we divide it by area, then we have pressure due to centrifugal force. Okay. The pressure resulted by the centrifugal force will be in outward direction, and this due to height, it will be different. This direction, inward direction. Okay. So the final pressure is your 2 to rho omega square r square. Okay. And the initial pressure is your 3. Due to centrifugal force, the pressure is rho omega square r square, and due to height, it is rho gh. Okay. So, but the net pressure is given as after rotation is PA by 2. Okay. From this, we can see that omega solving this equation. So, we have PA plus 2 rho gh, where the rho r square, so option A is the right answer. Next. An incompressible fluid at a pressure of 150 kPa absolute flows steadily through a two-dimensional channel with velocity of 5 meter per second as shown here. The channel has 90 degree bend. The fluid leaves the channel at a pressure of 100 kPa absolute. Okay. And linearly varying velocity profile V max is 4 times V min. Okay, the density of the fluid is 914.3 kg per meter cube and velocity V mean in meter per second. So this is the figure given here. The fluid is entering at 5 meter per second and the diameter and this dimension is 15 mm, this dimension is also 15 mm. Okay. And here there is variation in velocity. Here this velocity is bigger than this. Okay. Now for steady flow, for steady flow, the continuity equation must be satisfied. Okay. So A1 V1 should be equal to A2 VF V2. And here the velocity is constant, so we can take as 5 meter per second. Area here at here is same, so A1 is equal to A2. Okay. So and V average here is V max, because it is linearly increasing, so it is V max plus V min by 2. Okay. So V average here is 5, and here it is V max plus V min by 2. Okay. So as area are equal, okay. So V average is equal to V average 1 is equal to V average 2. So V average 2 is equal to 5, and V max plus V min is 10. And the relationship between V max and V min is 4 V min. Okay. From this, we can figure V min, that is 2 meters per second. Okay. correct answer is your C option. Next, the velocity vector corresponding to a flow field is given with usual notation V is equal to 3xi plus 4xy j. The magnitude of rotation at the point 2, 2 in radian per second is option A 0.75, B 1.33, C 3, D 4. So this is your velocity 3xi plus 4xy j. Here u is 3x and v is your 4xy. Now we have to, as it is automatic flow, so in x and y axis, so there will be omega z, and omega z is given by 1 by 2 curly u by curly y minus curly v by curly x. Okay. Curly u by curly y is nothing but 0, and curly v by curly x is your 4 by x, which is minus 1 into, sorry, it is minus 1 into 4 by 2, okay, or it is minus 2 y, so it's quantity 0. Putting the value of x as 2 and y as 2, and there is no x, so answer is 0. Maybe positive or negative depending on the clockwise or anticlockwise direction rotation. Okay, so answer is answer are in positive values. Okay, so answer is your 4. Answer D. Next, the stream function for a potential flow field is given as psi is equal to x square minus y square. The corresponding potential function assuming zero potential at the origin is x square plus y square. D 2xy minus x square minus y square dx minus 1. So this is the stream function, that is psi is equal to x square minus y square, and we know that u is equal to minus psi by y. Okay, so it will be minus 2y, and u is equal to, in terms of your potential function, is minus psi by x. Okay, so as it is u is minus 2y, so it is 2y. Okay, now minus minus sign will cancel out, and then integrating we will have 2y plus x, 2yx plus c. Okay. Now, at origin, the velocity position is 0. Okay. So, y is 0 at 0, x is equal to 0. So, c is also 0. So, answer is y will be 2xy or 2yx. Answer is b. Next, fully developed flow of an oil takes place in a pipe of inner diameter 50 mm. The pressure drop per meter length of a pipe in 2 kPa. Determine the shear stress in Pascal at the pipe wall. Now we know that in case of fully developed flow and in case of laminar flow, okay, in a pipe we have the shear stress relationship with the pressure gradient and this. Okay, shear stress is minus curly pi by curly x into r by 2. If r is your this pressure drop per unit length is your 2 kPa, okay, and R is your 25 mm as radius is, as diameter is 50, okay, so radius is 25, so you can calculate shear stress on the wall, that is 25 Pascal. Next, the Darcy friction factor F for a smooth pipe is given as F is equal to 64 by RE. For laminar flow, and F is equal to 0.3 divided by RE 0.25. For tubular flow, where RE is the Reynolds number based on the diameter, for the fully developed flow of a fluid of density 1000 kg per meter cube and then it is equal to 0.01 Pascal second through a smooth wall pipe of diameter 10 mm with a velocity of 100 per second. That's the reflection. So, first of all, we have to use the first of all, we have to calculate the Reynolds number. Okay, to use this, to use this formula which we have to use. Okay, so by using the Reynolds number, we will find out that the flow is laminar or turbulent. Okay, so rho is your 1000. Okay, Reynolds number is rho by mu. Rho is your 1000, and this mu is your 0.001, and v is your diameter is 10 mm and B is 1 meter. Okay, from this we have Reynolds number 10,000. Okay, now as it is more than 4000, so it is turbulent flow. Okay, so you use this formula and the unit for it. Okay, next, air flows freely through a channel. The stagnation and static pressure at a point in the flow are measured by figure. You add a wall pressure tab. Respectively, the pressure difference is found to be 20 mm of Hg. Densities of air, water, and mercury is in kilogram per meter cube. Air are 1.18,000 and 13,600 respectively. The gravitational acceleration is 9.8 meter per second squared. Determine the airspeed. So this is the same question that has been asked in previous papers. Okay. So now we know that the stagnation pressure is the total pressure and static pressure. Difference is your dynamic pressure, total pressure minus static pressure, dynamic pressure, and dynamic pressure is nothing but half rho u square. Okay, half rho u square. And as this pressure has been measured, so it is given by rho m gh, and rho m is your mercury fluid, that is 13,600. Okay, and g is 9.81, and h is your 20 mm. Okay, so and this for air, the rho is your 1.18 given. Okay, so from this we can get just to get this 67.25. Okay, next, common data for question 17 and 18. The velocity field within a laminar boundary layer is given by the expression v is equal to b u infinity by x is equal to t by 2 I. Okay, and b u infinity y square u x rate for pi by 2 j. Okay, where b is 10, b is 100 meter per square meter, and the pressure in the field u infinity is 0.1 meter per second. Calculate the x direction component of acceleration in meter per second. Add the point x is equal to 0.5 and y is equal to 50 mm. And this is the first question. Second question is, find the slope of the streamline passing through the point x is equal to 0.5 meter and y is equal to 50 mm. So this is your y. Okay. And so this will be u, and this will be your v component. Yeah, or velocity in x direction and velocity in y direction. Okay, this is v. Vector of v. Okay. So this is u. Okay. Now, to find out acceleration and x direction, we have du by dt. Curly by curly x, curly x by curly t, and curly u by curly by curly by curly t, and curly u by curly t. As curly u by curly x is your, we have differentiated the two, x, okay, and curly x by curly t is u, okay. Curly u by curly y is differentiation of this, and curly u by curly t is this quantity, okay, and there is no t in this, so this will be 0. Okay, so differentiation of this will be v u infinity by x minus 3 by 2. Minus 1, input, minus 3 by 2, okay, and u will be your b u infinity x by 3 by 2, okay, and similarly differentiation of this is b u, this is 5 by 2, okay, so this is x 3 by 2, okay, so this is, sorry, this is your, sorry, this will be x 3 by 2, and here it will be b u infinity u square 4 x 5 by 2. Okay, this is your tool. Okay, so it will be curly u by curly y. Sorry, here we have to do curly u by curly y. Okay. So curly u by curly y is this. Okay. So there will be b u infinity x c. Okay. Okay. and here it is semi-variability, so it is your your B component. Okay, so this is your AX. Okay, this is AX. Okay, now we can solve it out. Now x is your minus 5 by 2 and here this is minus 3 by 2. Okay, and it should be 5 by 2 plus 3 by 2. So it is a mathematical equation. Okay, so these are correct. So you can see that. Now the common is your b, u square, y square, and x, x4. Okay, here it is again x4. Okay, so minus 3 by 2 plus 1 by 4. So putting the value of b, b is given, b is your 100, u is your 0.1 and u is 0.1 and 50, y is your 50, x is your 0.5. Putting these values we can get this acceleration as minus 5. So acceleration, F component of equation is minus 5. Okay. Now second is slope of the streamline passing through the point x is equal to 0.5. And now we know the slope is v by v, v is your v u is by y square by 4x x for pi by 2 and q is equal v u is by x is for c by 2. Okay. So v will cancel out, u will cancel out, y will be there. Okay, and x will be there. Okay, and both putting by and x, we can get log to answer here 0.05. Okay, to answer the expression 0.05. Next, common data question for 19 and 20. The wave and eddy resistance of a sea going vessel 96 meter in length, driven at a velocity of 12 meter per second is to be determined. For this purpose, 1 by 16 scale model is employed in fresh water and coefficient of resistance CWE of the model is found to be 1.47 × 10⁻⁴. The quality CV is defined as FWE divided by rho V square L square by 2, where FWE is a wave and eddy resistance, rho is density, V is velocity, and L is characteristic length. Density of sea water is 1026 kg per meter cube. The velocity in meter per second at which the model is powered is option A 0.75, B 1.33, C 3, D 192. Second question is the resistance of the prototype in kilometers. Okay, so here the resistance length is given as length is given 96 meter and velocity is given 12 meter per second. Okay, we have to determine the resistance of this. Okay, and the scale model is 1 by 16. Okay, now it is applied in fresh water. Okay, so using the Proud number relationship. Okay, so here V by root L is equal to V by root L. Okay. And 1 by 16 model is there. So we take here 96 by 16. Okay. So we find out the velocity Vm. Okay. So this is the first answer. So velocity of the model is down. Okay. Now we have to determine the resistance of the prototype. Okay. The resistance of is given by the relationship coefficient of resistance. Okay, the quality of CWE is, okay, this is given as FWE by rho V scale L scale. Okay, now this is CWE is given as coefficient of resistance here, and this value is for model is 1.47. okay, value is, okay, for the model is 1.47 and it is given as this relationship. Okay, now we have V, we have L, we have rho. Okay, so FW, we can find out FW. Okay, though is your possibility is 1026, V is your 3 meters per second, and L is your 6. Okay. L is your 6 in anticipation. From this, we can find out FWE. Now, FWE is dependent upon V square, L square, and rho square. So, rho V L square, okay. Or it is rho V square L square, okay. Or it is dependent on FW L cube. So, for model and prototype, as density is same for both the group. So this is the for the here it is FWE by FPE. Okay. So FWE from this we can find out. It will be 1000. Or we can find out FWE. This is your FWE. Putting the value of FWE, we can find out this one can get 100.1 kilonewton. Okay. Next. The statement for link answer question 21 and 22. The water enters a symmetrically closed pipe and discharges into statement for link bank question 21 and 22. When water enters the symmetrically formed pipe and discharges into the atmosphere, two branches as shown in figure. The cross section area of section 1 and 1 is 0.2 meter square, and velocity of velocity cross section 1 is 3 meter per second. The density of water may be taken as 1000 kilogram meter per cube. The viscous effect and the elevation changes may be neglected. Okay. So here the we have to find out the gauge pressure at section 1 in KPA 0.6, option 0.6, B 13.5, C 135, and D 600. The magnitude of the force in kilonewton required to hold the pipe in place is 2.7, hyperfort, 19, and 27. So this is the pipe, and here the pressure you have to find out. Okay, and A1 and A2 are same. Okay, A1 and A2 are same. So A2 and A3 are same, and it is equal to A1 by 4. Okay, so here now discharge here. The water is coming here and leaving out here. Okay. So Q1 is equal to Q2 by Q2 plus Q3. Okay, so but Q2 is equal to Q3 by because area is same. Okay, and area is same, and the flow is steady. Okay, so Q2 is equal to Q3. So we can say that Q2 is equal to Q1 by 2. So as Q1 is 3, velocity at the question area of 1 is 0.2, and velocity is 3. Okay. So discharge here is 0.3 into 2.2. Okay, so it will be Q2 is 0.3 meter cube per second. Okay, so velocity at 0.2 is A2V2, and A2 is nothing but A1 by 4. Okay, and A1 is nothing but 0.2. Okay. So from this we can have velocity at 0.26 meter per second. So we can, now we can apply the Bernoulli's equation here and here. So here at 0.1, it is P1 by 1 plus U square by 2G and Z1, okay. And here again P2 by 1G and P2 square by 2G and Z2. So as both are, this is a horizontal figure, so both are at the same level, okay. So Z1 can be taken as equal to Z2. Okay. And P2 is atmosphere, so it is 0. Okay. And V1, V2 we have. Now the force required to hold the pipe in place is the force that is driven by the water. Okay, M is the mass flow rate of water and change in velocity in acceleration plus your pressure at pressure force at section 1. Okay. So this is the mass is your Q into 1000 and your change in velocity initially it is 3 and at in x direction it is at x direction it is 6. Okay, so this is your 6 4 theta 460 and the pressure at relative this is so answer here to put 7 kilonewton option D. You can actually the answer is given to okay, thank you.